I'm Buddy Dodd from His Kids Radio and HisKids.net, and today we're going geocaching for the very first time. We're at Indiana Dunes State Park, and we rented a GPS unit. Basically, you're on a technological treasure hunt. You know, one of the bikes broke down, so Grandpa's back with Tammy. They're fixing that. I sent the GPS with Nathan and the other kids, and they're like 100 feet away from the prize.
Did you guys find it? How'd you get back there? Whoa, big spider. So what is it?
It's an ammo box.
It's an ammo box. Is it tied down?
No.
It was underneath.
It was right there.
So what's in there so far? Pencils?
Pencils, yeah.
Log books and McDonald's toys.
Here's a stamp.
This is our first box, and Josh is going to hold it up into the sun so you can see it says geocache. Please do not disturb. So we're going to put it back in the bottom of this tree for the next person to find it. Okay, before we go on our second one, we're going to reset the GPS unit. This is what it looks like. You hold it in your hand, put in the coordinates, and it tells you what direction to go and how far you need to go to get there. Okay, we're about 400 feet away, and Nathan and Josh got distracted by a dune lizard. Okay, we didn't have much luck at the last one, Fig. Actually, the kids went up over the hill and found where it's supposed to be, but it looked like the tube might have fallen out the tree and gotten picked up and taken away by somebody that didn't know better. So we went back and got some lunch, dropped off the little kids, picked up a big one. Hey, Jonathan. And now we're going to go find another one called Duck M. And that's up on Trail 3. And we're going to see how we do with that one. This is a picture of perseverance and decisions. Okay, we've broken up into two teams. Jonathan went back the other way with Alex, Josh, and the radio. But Nathan says we're within feet over here. Guys, I think we found it.
It says, DNR, do not remove. Contact 97.
I think we found it.
See, look, there's those thingies.
We're gonna trade this in so we can put it back in for safekeeping for other people so they can trade stuff back in. Ta-da!
Okay, for our next one, we chose one that was 0.05 miles from the Nature Center. Nathan has the GPS. Jonathan thinks he might have stumbled upon it.
Ooh, a steak quarter.
Hey, I like steak quarters.
What's in here? Oh, a yo-yo.
It's a yo-yo.
Yo-yo's good, right?
Sure.
It's expensive.
This thing is expensive.
And there's only one more geocache that we haven't found. That's by the Calumet Bike Trail for the Indiana Dunes State Park. So that's where we're going to head next. Then we're going to turn this in. Then we're going to turn this into a cool video. Okay, the GPS told us to hop off the road and get on this path that leads to the bike trail. You just heard in the walkie-talkie that they found it back here on the trail.
Hey, Nathan got the GPS, but I saw it.
Good. So this is our last cache for the day, actually, but we decided not to trade anything out. Why not, Nate?
Because this thing is the best one we found, and that one got, like, totally blown up and everything's wet and ripped, and so this is worth it all the way.
Did you guys have fun today?
Yeah!
Okay, big question is, would you do it again?
Yeah!
best thing I can think of to do after a long day of geocaching, maybe drink a bottle of water and go jump in a lake.
Can you ask how to stop the flip video thing?